Hi, my name is Greta Zenner. I'm the Assistant Director of Education at the University of Wisconsin-Madison for the Materials Research Science and Engineering Center. That's a mouthful, so we just call it UW-MRSEC. Our center does research on nanostructured interfaces. In other words, we explore the nano world. Nanotechnology is all around us. It's in the movies we see, the books we read, and the products we use and buy every day. This slide has some examples of nano in our everyday lives. Some movies that talk about nanotechnology include the Spider-Man movies, Agent Cody Banks, and the Hulk. Books like Michael Crichton's Prey and comic books like Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles also talk about nano. Nanotechnology is also in many of the products we use and buy every day, such as stain-resistant clothing, self-cleaning windows, hard drives, and lighter and stronger car parts, such as the running board on the GMC van pictured here. The iPod is another example of nano, although it's actually more nano buzz than actual nanotechnology. The iPod Nano does contain nanotechnology, but no more than your regular desktop computer. Apple uses the word nano primarily because it's a trendy word, and because they wanted to emphasize that the iPod Nano is their smallest iPod yet. But it's not actually nano-sized. Later in this segment, I'll talk a little more about the size of nano and what nano actually is. Things are different at the nanoscale compared to the macroscale. While things like gravity are important on the macroscale in our everyday lives, things on nanoscale are different. This means that sometimes things don't behave on the nanoscale like they do on the macroscale. Gold is one example. There are big differences between nanoscale and macroscale gold. How do you think the color of the two kinds of gold differ? What about the melting point? This slide contains some images of nanoscale and macroscale gold. On the left is a flask that contains a solution of gold nanoparticles. Nanogold can look red depending on the particle size. Definitely not what we would consider a traditional gold color. This particle size makes a solution that looks more like cranberry juice than gold. On the right is a World Cup trophy, an example of macroscale gold. This gold looks more like what we can think of as traditional gold. In addition to the color, the melting points of nano versus macroscale gold differ. The melting point of nanoscale gold is a lot lower than macroscale gold, approximately 600 degrees Celsius lower. Part of what nanotechnology does is using these exciting differences between the nano world and the macroscopic world to create new materials. These new materials have the potential to greatly impact society or the world around us. Based on this potential impact, some are talking about a nanotechnology revolution, that in the future, our world will be completely different, all because of nanotechnology. However, trying to predict how big of an impact nanotechnology will have is very challenging. The graph here compares this task to trying to predict the impact cars or the computer have had on society. Can you imagine back in 1950 trying to predict the impact computers would have on society? It would have been really hard. Trying to predict the future impact of nanotechnology is equally challenging. In thinking about the future of nanotechnology, it's important to differentiate between hype and reality. Some of the things that people say nanotechnology will do, like create tiny robots that self-replicate, are more hype than reality. It's unlikely that self-replicating nanobots will actually happen. However, there are still a lot of exciting things that nanotechnology might do, like create better medicines and help clean up the environment. These applications fall under the reality heading. Many of the exciting, real potential applications of nanotechnology involve an important molecule called a buckyball, or a fullerene. A buckyball is composed of 60 carbon atoms bonded together in the shape of a soccer ball. To help you understand exactly how small a buckyball is, let's do a comparison. If you magnify a buckyball to the size of a soccer ball and magnify a soccer ball the same relative amount, how big do you think the new size of the soccer ball would be? The answer is the planet Neptune. Neptune is a lot bigger than a soccer ball, which means that a soccer ball is a lot bigger than a buckyball. Now that we've talked about where nano is in our everyday lives, what's different about the nano world, and what nano might do in the future, it's important to understand exactly how small the nanoscale and the nanometer are. This slide contains a lot of information, but I'll walk you through it and help you understand everything, especially in relation to the nano world. A helpful way of thinking about how small the nano world is to think in steps of 1,000. We'll start out at the meter scale, with things that are about the size of a meter. 1 meter is about the size of Mini-Me from the Austin Powers movies. For those of you who know scientific notation, 1 meter is 10^0 meters. If we step down a scale of 1,000, we can look inside Mini-Me's eye. This is the millimeter scale. A millimeter is 10^-3 meters, which means that there are 1,000 millimeters in a meter. An example of research work at this scale are tiny devices scientists and engineers are working on to help people see better, as shown in this picture of a chip from Mini-Me's eye. That's a very small chip, but if we step down another scale of 1,000, we can still make and see tiny gears. This is the micrometer, or micron scale. A micrometer is 10^-6 meters, which means that there are 1,000,000 micrometers in a meter. These gears are approximately the same scale as the diameter of your hair, about 40-80 microns. Bacteria, which are 3-5 microns, are also on the micrometer scale. This is extremely small, but not as small as nano. To get to nano, we need to step down one more scale of 1,000. Finally, we're in the world of the nanometer, or 1/1,000,000 of a meter, or 10^-9 meters. Objects at this scale include carbon nanotubes and buckyballs. Other, perhaps more familiar objects at this scale include viruses, which are 3-50 nanometers, and DNA, the diameter of which is 1-2 nanometers. This is also the world of atoms. If you could line up 10 hydrogen atoms, the smallest of all the atoms, side by side, they would be 1 nanometer in length. That's extremely small. To give you more help in understanding exactly how small the nanoscale is, here are some more fun facts. Did you know that your fingernails grow approximately 1 nanometer in the time it takes to read a sentence? And here's another comparison one. If the atoms in your body were magnified to the size of golf balls, how tall do you think you would be? The answer? You would be able to reach the moon. That's almost 400,000 kilometers. This shows that even though golf balls are pretty small, they are still a lot bigger than atoms. I've told you about the nano world today, the place of nano in our everyday lives, the potential of nano, the uniqueness of the nano world, and the size of the nano world. If you would like to know more, please visit our website, www.mersec.wisc.edu/nano.